дня. Доброго вечора. Ми раді вітати вас в цей прекрасний четвер у Кракові. Чудова погода, сонячні лучі ніжно обгортають наші змерзлі щочки. Багато інформації будете сьогодні сприймати і візуально, і аудіовально.
Hey. So like, 2 weeks ago, we stumbled upon this sick movie on dis.art, right? And we just couldn't get enough of it because it was, like, the perfect reflection of our times and everything we're trying to break free from, you know? We're totally vibing with it. The flick's called The Metaverse in Janky Capitalism by the super cool guy from London, Daniel Falstead. And guess what? He's down to chat with us after I hit him up last week. He's bringing along Jen Leung, who did all those wicked 3D animations for the movie, and I'll be rep-pin our crew with Julia Timmies and Julia Mazur, cruising together on the green ship. First, if haven't watched, we invite you for the first 10 minutes. The whole thing is on now, for limited time only at dis.art.
The metaverse is like the real world, it turns out, with experts now warning some of the problems we have IRL are going virtual with us.
Yeah, 16,000.
I'm just gonna start off by saying, like, if you get it, you get it. If you don't, you don't. If you know, you know. And if you don't know, like, I honestly feel bad for you. Like, I cannot explain it. Like, I don't have the vocabulary to sit here and explain it. Like, either you get the vibe or you don't get the vibe.
We are living in the age of janky capitalism, like, seriously, planetary scale computation, you know, where online and offline are no longer two separate spaces one enters in and exits from.
I'm here live. I'm not a cat.
An age where the 4K render of a slick speculative future, you know, seeps into our laggy presence of social neglect, political paralysis, and fucking economic perversity.
You did?
Trapped in the swampy mush of janky capitalism, we go about our extremely online lives through a stack of patchy and incoherent layers of, you know, intersecting yet competing platforms, services, and protocols that literally augment, fashion, and frustrate our everyday activities in unforeseen, badly designed, and seriously malicious ways.
It's really interesting when people come into chat and they accuse me of being fake. I don't disagree with you. I don't know who my authentic self is on stream yet. Every single day that I come on here, I discover new things about myself that I'm willing to share with you.
Why are you so obsessed with me? Boy, I wanna know. Lying that you're sexing me when everybody knows.
I was only gone for the last few months.
You know, leading up to the latter half of 2021. To be honest, the metaverse came to function as a fucking messy and, like, kind of cringe, but convenient shorthand for the stack. A stack made up of Instagram thirst traps, Twitter shitposts, Telegram cat deals, OnlyFans kink subscriptions, WhatsApp family group chat, Zoom fatigue, TikTok challenges, World of Warcraft guilds, Fortnite skins, and Twitch streams.
Did you know that in terms of male, human, and female Pokemon breeding, Vaporeon is the most compatible Pokemon for humans?
All of which, whilst literally degrading, and you know, that shit crazy, like, nevertheless kind of works, I guess.
Something about an NFT project called Schizo Posters, and that he needs to get home as soon as possible to purchase these? Now, I am not sure what exactly a Schizo Poster is, but apparently the man is in some kind of a manic state, yelling about a fire sale for this NFT project.
However, on the 28th of October 2021, in that totally wild video presentation, the Zuck not only rebranded Facebook in its honor, but, you know, also presented a spectacularly lame and super cringe vision of what the metaverse is and will be.
Experience.
In this delusional fever dream, the metaverse is presented as a lobotomized William Gibson hellscape, fabricated from presentation decks of fucking mid-naughties new media agencies with names like, you know, Hyper Res, Deep ROM, and Razor Squid. The Zuck defines the metaverse as a virtual environment where you can be present with people in digital space. An embodied internet that you're inside of rather than just looking at.
Perfect.
Zuck is like, oh my God, guys, don't be a total simp stuck in the past, doom scrolling endlessly on your phone like a zombie. Like, wake up, baby girl. The metaverse is here and it's about to change everything. This isn't just another online world. It's like a whole new fucking universe that combines the best of social media, online gaming, augmented and virtual reality, and crypto. It's like stepping into Ready Player One, but even better. You can work from anywhere, like collaborate with people from all over the world, and you know, attend virtual events and conferences that will actually blow your mind. And when it's time to decompress, you can chill, meet new people, and like play games that are next level immersion. Sorry to crash the party, sweetheart, but let's be real here. Like, sure, the Zuck is talking a big game about this so-called metaverse, but, like, what the fuck is actually going on here? Firstly, I mean, like, if we're using the term metaverse as a shorthand for 3D gaming-like environments, then let's not fucking forget that. Like, virtual worlds where you can exist as an avatar with other users have been around, you know, for almost 2 decades now. And in that time, gaming has become, like, a major cultural and economic force in its own right, with over 3 fucking billion active gamers and an annual revenue of $200 billion. So forgive me if I'm a bit fucking skeptical about all the hype around the metaverse, darling, but oh my God, seriously. Yo, bro, just chill. I really don't think you want to do that. Anyway, in this light, the metaverse can be seen as little more than a colonizing land grab of a rich territory by fucking Web 2 giants, whose stranglehold on our attention, emotions, and content is threatened by the gaming industry.
This boss is so fucking stupid.
Are you still stuck on Margit?
Yes, this asshole keeps fucking dodging my attacks.
You are such a dipshit.
Shut the fuck up. You have 500 hours on this game, and this is my first goddamn playthrough.
So, loves, beyond just labeling any and every fucking video game or virtual environment as the metaverse, what is actually, like, being built? Well, let me break it down for you. There are, like, 3 basic metaversal prototypes being built: aesthetics, mechanics, and infrastructure. AAA games like Fortnite and Call of Duty are, you know, all about aesthetics. They are what the metaverse aspires to look and feel like, but their systems are walled gardens. This means that the game's owners get to fucking control everything from the narratives to the functionality. So not cool for the decentralized interoperative heads out there. Then there are games like Minecraft and Roblox. These are a different type of game, one closer to the ideal vision of the metaverse in terms of the game mechanics, where users can build their own assets and worlds. But don't get too excited, they're still closed worlds.
Cash, I'm talking to you, come back over here.
Shut up, I'm gonna follow Robbie.
Project X.
Finally, we have platforms that are based on Web3 technology such as Decentraland, The Sandbox, and Spatial. These platforms are said to be building the infrastructure which enables users to buy, display, and sell virtual land, NFT artwork, and other digital assets using crypto. These platforms are built with interoperability in mind, meaning, in principle, it will be easier to connect with other platforms. For the love of God, please make it stop. So, listen, hun, let me tell you something about this so-called metaverse. Zuck and the boys are, like, getting hard on this fantasy about it being a fully immersive and embodied experience. But honestly, have you actually seen the way